What's going on, guys? It is Bernardo, and yes, another MDT video. And today is all about continuing our process and getting our MDT server up and running to successfully deploy Windows 11. So let's get right into it. All right, so on the last video, we left off here. We received this, and I told you guys on that video at the end of it, hopefully you guys stay tuned to the very end. I said that I was going to do a continuation on fixing this problem, but when I was trying to fix this problem within my lab, I received other problems. It's crazy. So, how to fix this problem? Super simple to fix this problem. And the way that we're going to fix the problem, and I had to do this. You have to remove the latest and greatest Windows ADK and then go back to the previous ADK. But when you do this, it causes more problems into your MDT environment, which we will fix. All right, so within my MDT server, I loaded up the control panel. The Windows ADK that I have is 10.1.25398.1. This is the latest version. So we go inside this site. They give you an option to click on other ADK downloads. When you click on this, it takes you to this. And the one that we want would be Windows 11 for version 22H2. This is the one that we are going to download. So I clicked on the first link. It downloaded the ADK setup. I clicked on the second link. It downloaded the ADK WinPE setup for us. So go back inside the control panel, select your Windows ADK, click on uninstall, click yes here, and just uninstall the feature. Once it's done, it's going to give you this. Click on close, select your Windows PE, click on uninstall, click yes. Let it do its thing. Once it's done, it's going to give you this. Click close. Open up your downloads folder and click on the ADK setup. Right click on it, run it as an administrator. Click next here. I'm going to say no, click next. Accept the license and terms, click install, and install the Windows ADK. Again, we're going backwards. We're not using the latest ADK because it's causing a lot of problems with MDT 8456. So we're going maybe the last version before they pushed out the crappy one to MDT. We're going to click close here. We're going to select our Windows ADK WinPE setup. Right click on it, run it as an administrator, click next here, click next, accept the license and terms, click install. It's going to start installing and you're done, and we're going to close it. Now, if you go back inside control panel, programs and features, you're going to see that now you're running 10.1.22.621.1. Open up your deployment workbench, right click on your deployment share, go to update deployment share, and select completely regenerate the boot images. Click next here, click next. Once it's completed, you're going to get this, click finish. Once you're done, head over to your WDS server, replace the boot image, restart the server, and then validate and test out. Within my lab, I was like, yes, I fixed the problem. That error that we received at the very beginning did not show up, but I received this. I was clicking yes, 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 but the dialog box wasn't going away. I was able to close it, select my task sequence, and it deployed successfully, but it failed at the very end, which was weird. Now, how to fix this problem? Now, to fix this problem, let's head over to our MDT server. We're going to open up our File Explorer. Let's go inside the C drive. Within the C drive, let's go to Programs and Files, open up Microsoft Deployment Toolkit. Within here, let's go to Templates. Within the Templates folder, let's locate unintend_pe_x64.xml. Now, we're going to make a copy of this. We're going to select the original. We're going to right-click on it. We're going to click on Edit, and we're going to pick Notepad. This is what we have, and this is what we need to replace it with. And Microsoft actually gives you this within their site. So I didn't get this like a third-party site. I got this from the Microsoft site. So we're going to copy this. We're going to paste it here. We're going to close the file. We're going to click on Save. We're going to go back inside our deployment workbench. We're going to right-click on our deployment share. We're going to select Update Deployment Share. From here, I select the Completely Regenerate the Boot Image. Click Next. Click Next. and we're done, and then we're finished. Now, once you regenerate the boot image, I like to go inside the WDS server and then replace the image and then restart the services. I'm going to show you guys how to do it because I didn't show you before. So I logged into the server that is running my WDS services. Within boot images, I selected the boot image. I right-clicked on it. I selected replace image. I clicked on browse, and I browsed into the network path of my server, my MDT server, inside deployment share boot, and I selected my x64 WIM file, right? That's the one that we regenerated again. Click on open, click next here, click next. You are able to change the image name and the image description. This is up to you. I left it as a default. I typically do. Click next, and it's going to start replacing the boot image with the new one. And then once you're done, you're going to get this. Click on finish. And for me, within my environment, I like to select the server, right-click on it, go to all tasks, and then restart the services, and then I get this. Go back, create a new virtual machine, pixie boot into the virtual machine, test again, see if it works out. But no. Microsoft is, you guys are doing dirty with MDT. Come on, man. Show MDT some love. It's a free utility. Why? Okay, so I received this problem. And I received verified BCDBootEx. And I actually did a video for you guys on this. So you guys can actually check that out. But I'm going to show you how to fix it here really quick. So to fix the BCDBootEx problem, there is a VB script that is called Fix UEFI Detection. Now, I have it on the desktop. And again, if you want more details on how and why and what's inside this script, head over to the other video. But this script needs to be dropped into the following path. So I'm going to open up my dpartition because this is where my deployment share is located. So open up the deployment share folder. Within here, we're going to go inside scripts. Within this folder, I'm going to paste that VB script in there. Now, open up your deployment workbench. Go inside task sequence, double click on the task sequence that you want to make modifications into. Go to task sequence, and then within here, inside pre-install, and inside the pre-install folder, there's another folder called new computer only. Within here, we're going to click on add. We're going to select general. Within general, we are going to select run command line. We're going to give the run command line the following name. This is up to you. You could name it whatever you want. But for the command line, you got to give it the following. We're calling out that VB script that we added into our script folder. And we're going to apply it. But that run command needs to be moved right underneath the validate option. So we're going to move it up. And it's going to be validate, the fix, format. Copy script. That's the way that we need to do it. So just move it right between validate and format the partition disk. Once you've done that, we're going to apply it. We're going to okay it. We're going to right click on our deployment share. We're going to update our deployment share. I'm going to leave it as optimize the boot image. Click next and let it complete itself and then restart the WDS and then test again. If you got to this point right here, don't go anywhere because I'm going to show you guys a quick video of me deploying Windows 11 successfully with MDT. I know it does not have the latest Windows ADK, but Microsoft is not showing any love with MDT at all. I mean, it's, you got to use what you have. It kind of sucks because the Windows ADK that I install, I'm not able to push out Windows 11 23H2 because of the Windows ADK. And that's it, guys. Hopefully you guys enjoyed this video and I catch you guys on the next one. Peace out.